One of the reasons we teach math is to show children how to solve problems. Not just math problems, but real-world problems. And Overruled facilitates that perfectly. And just like with most of our animations, we watch it once for fun, and the second time around, I ask the children to look for specific things. Number one, what did they use to solve the problem? See if you guys can figure out how to put that into words. Number two, looking for the math vocabulary, all of the different math words that they talk about.
Why have you not built the bridge 12 noble feet high?
Said the Queentopian engineer.
What? Of course we have. Why have you not built the bridge 12 noble feet high?
What do we generally use to measure things?
Rulers.
Rulers? And what do rulers have on them?
Inches.
Inches? What's another measurement that we use to measure things besides inches? Savion? Initially, we talk about the importance of vocabulary so that students are talking the same language in terms of measurement. Then we get into the mechanics of graphing, so spacing, labeling, where the axes go. And then after all of that is taken care of, we get into different ways of solving problems. What's another measurement system?
Meters.
Meters. So metric system. What goes with the metric system? Do you have meters?
Kilometers.
Kilometers. What about smaller units? Do we have conversion tables? Do you have to convert sometimes when you're dealing with inches and centimeters? Okay. So that's kind of the same issue that they're having here. So my question for you is this. What if they would have put the queen's feet here and the king's feet here? Would the graph be the same? What's the most important thing to do even before you start plotting points or doing anything else? What do you got to do first?
Drawing the X and Y axis.
So you draw the X and Y axis, and then what else? Nate?
Label the
Got a label. You got to label your X and Y axis, right? How did they solve the problem in the video? Let's see. Right here, Naomi.
They used a graph.
They used a graph. Can anybody think of any other way to do it? Nate?
They, learned how to convert the queen's feet into king's feet.
How did they learn? How did they figure out how to convert? What did they use?
The graph.
The graph. Is there any other way that they could have learned how to convert? Renee?
Use a table.
They could have used a table. Okay, so that's another strategy they could have used. Can anybody think of a different strategy that they may have used? So my challenge to you is, when we start doing our activities, I want you guys to see if you can think of different ways that they could have solved this problem, okay? For me, it's very important to integrate vocabulary throughout the lesson. So as words come up, we put them on the board so that at the end we can talk about all of the wonderful math that they're learning. Right now, we're gonna collect some data so that the students can solve their own problems, and they're gonna get some special feet to do it. How could you mark that? How could I take this foot and cut it in half or mark fourths or thirds? What would I do with this foot? Natalie? I could fold the paper in half. How would I mark fourths? I gave the students 10 minutes to go around the room and measure various objects with the different sized feet. And then they put their information in a table. The great thing about this activity is that it's more meaningful to them because it's their data. We took all of the classroom data and put it into a class table. After we had the class table, we transferred that onto a class graph. This led to some wonderful classroom discussion. Again, what are the things that I have to keep in mind? I have everything labeled. I did it opposite from the video, because in the video they had the king's feet down here, they had queens up here. So we did it a little bit different. So I'm gonna take Well, that's okay. So I have 80 feet for the king, 68 feet for the queen. Is my graph big enough to handle that?
No.
Okay, so this one's not big enough to go on my graph. What could I have done differently here to make that one work? Nate, what could I have done differently?
You could have labeled the numbers differently. Instead of doing 1 to 10, you could have gone 20... 40, 60, 80.
Okay, so let's try doing it with the ones that we have, and then we'll talk about what you do with the graph when your graph runs out. Let's see, what's another one? The table height, that's a good one. So 8.5 king's feet and 6.5 queen, so 6.5. And I'm gonna go to 8.5, which is about right here. What do you notice?
A pattern.
Is it perfect?
No.
No. Why do you think, what would make it not perfect?
We could have measured wrong.
Yeah. I want the students to see the graph as a tool to find additional data points. It's not about measuring, it's about problem solving. So let's look at this pattern right here. So anytime that you have the comparison of the two numbers, what did we call that before? What's a comparison of two numbers? A what, Nate?
A ratio.
A ratio. So what was the ratio of the king's feet to the queen's feet? There are going to be some things that are seven king's feet. How am I going to figure out how many queen's feet they are? What's that going to be? Is it close to five? Mm-hmm. It's close to five, but what, if I were going to look at this, what would that be? 4 2/3. Is there another way that I could do that besides using the graph? So just because it is not a multiple doesn't mean that you can't figure it out. Don't be afraid to take the time to really go over the tables and the graphs. It's critical for the students to understand how this can be used for problem solving. And the learner guide facilitates that even further. I'm going to pass out the learner's guide. If you look at it, what does it look like it has there? There's what?
Feet.
Feet. Lots of feet. Are they all going to be the same as the ones we did here?
No.
No. If you have any questions, make sure that you ask. You need to ask your neighbor first. If both of you can't figure it out, then you call me over and I'll be happy to help you. So we're going to do this for about 15 minutes and we'll go from there.
Learner guides extend the lesson by asking students to apply the same mathematical concepts but under slightly different circumstances. In this case, the learner guide really showed me where the students were struggling and we seized it as a teachable moment.
There's one thing that I think we really, really, really need to talk about, because there's lots of different answers for this top problem. So I want to talk about this one a little bit. See all the different strategies that you use to figure it out, and then we'll see if we can figure out one of the best ways to do it.
At the end of every lesson, it's important to allow the students time to summarize their learning for that day so that you know what they do understand and what they're still struggling with. It gives them the time to think about how it connects to what they learned yesterday, and you the time to preview what's coming up tomorrow.
What did you learn today from the Queentopia and the Kingtopia video? What were some of the important key concepts?
One of the key concepts was to teach the people how to convert.
How to use a graph.
How to measure.
What occupations is measurement vitally important? Like where they have to be exact, Renee?
Architecture.
Can you imagine if they were even a little bit off? If they went from 2 2/3, they said, well, it looks kind of like 2 3/4. Nate?
Also, when you're piloting a plane.
When you're piloting a plane, if you're a little bit off, then that could cost you your life and lots of other people their lives too. So measurement is really, really, really important. And the other piece, when you're talking about a graph, what are the things that you have to do? And a table. What are your things, the most important thing with a graph and a table? You have to do what?
Label.
Label. Make sure that you label everything, because if you don't, then you end up with data that just doesn't work.
Mathematics isn't just about the algorithms and the formulas. It's about giving the students the tools to solve problems, not only in class, but in their real life. That's the beauty of being a math teacher.
In these lands, they measured a foot by the actual size of their king's or queen's foot.
Oh, I say, your feet are different sizes.
Let's talk feet, said the pedicurist. And everyone stopped to listen, because if anyone knew feet, it was the pedicurist. Henceforth in the territories, all subjects specified queen's feet or king's feet in all dealings with measurement.